Welcome to the Macworld video. I'm senior editor Dan Frakes. I've been reviewing iPod accessories since, well, pretty soon after the first iPod was released. That includes a good number of products designed to help you play your iPod's music through your car's stereo. Unfortunately, even the best of these products tend to leave stray cables, as well as your iPod, loose somewhere in your car. But does that really make any sense? I mean, when you think about it, the iPod is really just a modern-day mixtape. So why is it that car stereo vendors don't make head units that treat your iPod like a cassette? Well, one company, Fusion, has finally done just that. The CAIP 500 is a car stereo that forgoes a CD player in favor of an internal iPod dock that loads much like a cassette player. In this Macworld video, I'm going to show you a quick demo of this unique system. The CAIP 500 looks like many other aftermarket head units on the market these days, including their requisite fancy display and cheesy animation. Now, the head unit includes an AM/FM radio, and that radio has RDS support, so you can see exactly what station you're listening to and the name of the current track and the artist. You can change the display to see the different information. You can see an equalizer, and there's even a little screensaver here. Now, this shows everything from outer space to a clock to a car driving on a road, cityscapes, buildings. It's kind of cheesy, but it's pretty common these days. There's a pretty good menu system that lets you change your settings, for example, general, audio, display, RDS, and DAB. Just to give another example, display, you can set the dimmer to see how bright the screen is going to be, whether or not to show the screensaver, the graphic EQ style, and even change the button color. By that, it means the lights surrounding the buttons, either blue or white light. Now, even though there are no radio preset buttons on the unit, presets are pretty easy to access. You just press the tuner dial. That brings up a list of your presets. Turn the dial to highlight the one you want, and then press the dial again. You switch between sources using this button up here. Right now, all we've got are auxiliary and radio. But what makes this unit unique is that if you press the eject button, instead of seeing a CD player behind it, you see this dock. Funny, it's about the right size for an iPod. So you're probably wondering, well, how does my iPod fit in there securely? How does it not slide around? The answer is that Fusion provides a slew of these little adapters, and on each one it'll have a name. For example, this one here says bottom A. You can't really read it on the video, but this is a bottom A. And this is a top B. And then we've got one here that says bottom E. Now, the manual has a list that says, okay, if you've got a classic 80 gigabyte, you use top sleeve B and bottom sleeve A. And that gives me this. I slide my iPod Classic inside, and it's got actually felt pads on each side to prevent the iPod from getting scratched. And then this slides into the little dock, clicks into place. Once you've got the right adapter configuration, you can actually leave it inside the head unit and just pull your iPod out. It's as easy as just sliding it out and then sliding it back in when you want to use it again. The only time you really need to take the adapter out is if, for example, you wanted to use a different size iPod that uses a different adapter configuration. Now, once you shut the head unit's face and turn the unit on, you'll see that you actually have another audio source now, which is, of course, iPod. When you're in iPod mode, you can navigate the iPod's contents using the tuning knob, which also acts as a button and a joystick. Move the joystick to the right to skip ahead a song. Move it to the left to skip back. If you press the knob, you'll see the menus for playlist, artist, album, song, genre, and composer. Just like on the iPod, enter, and then you can browse the contents of that menu. Then you can go down and choose an artist, choose an album, and choose a song. Now, this menu system for navigating the iPod's contents works pretty well for short menus, things like genres or playlists. Where it breaks down is pretty much the same place that every car stereo with iPod support that I've tested breaks down, and that is for longer menus. For example, if you go into artist, takes a while for it to load the first time you press it, and you're turning and turning and turning and turning and turning, but it doesn't accelerate light the iPod's click wheel. Now my iPod has about 2,000 artists on it, and all those turns got me only through about the first 60 or 70. So unless you've got a lot of patience, you're not going to be using this to find a particular song or a particular artist. Instead, you're going to use it to access playlists or genres or other short lists. And in that respect, it works well. While testing the Fusion unit, I did find a couple minor issues. One of them is that the face, as with many car stereos nowadays, it detaches. But I found that this often happened while I was trying to close it. So even if it wasn't detached already, when I tried to close it, it would detach. Now the other issue is that I often found that when I took my iPod out, after quite a while of using it, it was very warm. There is the question of whether that's good for your iPod in the long run, but my guess is it's not hot enough to be a big problem. The CAIP 500 sells for about $250 and is available here in the US at Best Buy. It works with second, third, and fourth generation iPod Nanos, as well as all fifth generation, classic, and touch models. The system isn't perfect, but I give Fusion a lot of points for finally doing something that people have been waiting for a long time. Now you can get more information about the system in the show notes on macworld.com. Thanks for watching.